Hello friends, your prelims examination is around the corner and you have only 60 days at your disposal to write your prelims examination on June 3rd, 2018. If you ask me a question, what I can do in the next 60 days, I would say that what you cannot do in the next 60 days, which means that whatever is needed to crack the civil services prelims examination can be done in the next 60 days, provided if time is used judiciously. Whatever we are doing in the next 60 days will decide what we are going to do in the next 60 years. It also means one single day from today is equal to 1 year of our life. Friends, time is the most precious resource and time management is an essential life skill. We have next 60 days and what has to be done in the next 60 days. To help the students make their preparation very effective, we are presenting before you a model timetable of how to prepare for the next 60 days. One single day, we need to plan to study for 13 hours. So 13 hours a day, we have to allocate for our civil services prelims preparation. We have taken into account not just the need for study, we have also taken into account the time which you have to use for relaxing, taking rest and involving in some physical fitness activities and sufficient sleep, because here where we can do much more by effectively managing the time, thereby managing the stress which comes naturally when we prepare for the competitive examination. I told you that we have 13 hours study plan per day. Now, how to effectively use this 13 hours? How to divide the 13 hours? It is highly advisable that we'll have to allocate the time equally to all the subjects. For example, divide the 13 hours into 4 hour, 4 hour, 2 hours, and remaining 3 hours. In the first slot of 4 hours, we have to do general studies, one particular subject, say history, along with solving the question. In the second 4 hour, we have to do another GS subject, say polity, along with solving the question. The next 2 hours, we have to allocate for current affairs, because we know that 40 to 50% of questions last year came from current affairs. So next 2 hours, you have to plan for current affairs along with solving the question. Then remaining 1 hour, you have to give for CSAT. Half an hour, you have to give for map reading. And remaining 1.5 hours, you have to give for some areas like economic survey, India yearbook, and culture related topics. It is highly advisable that we'll have to select the 2 GS subjects which are having similarity in the subject matter, which have so much of sharing as far as the subject matter is concerned. For example, the combinations would be Indian polity combined with modern Indian history, because they have so much of sharing. Similarly, geography and environment, economy and polity. So this is how you have to combine 2 subjects so that you are getting the interconnectivity between these 2 subjects. Working candidates may ask me that I do not have 13 hours per day. So what is the solution for my problem? Your problem can be easily resolved by just dividing the 13 hours by 2. So half of the time which is available for the 13 hour per day people, you have, for example, 6.5 hours per day, you can use it. So if I say 4 hours for those who are studying for 13 hours, you do 2 hours. If I say 2 hours, you do that for 1 hour. So divide the 13 hour by 2 and use the time effectively so that you also can very easily clear this prelims examination. Friends, we need to have so much of positive attitude at this time point, because positive attitude will definitely increase the probability of success. At the same time, negative attitude reduces the probability of success. We have seen that those people who cleared the civil services examination, those who secured topmost ranks, they have not achieved in ideal conditions. they have achieved only in the adverse condition. So even though the conditions may be very adverse at this point of time, but with positive attitude, with proper planning, we'll be able to really achieve what we wanted to achieve in the next 60 days. Friends, success is not a product of accident. Success is only a product of commitment to excellence, smart planning, and focused efforts. There is a Chinese proverb which says that you need not be afraid of going slow, but definitely you have to be afraid of standing still. All the very best for your success. Thank you.